Warning: this video contains content you may find inappropriate or offensive. If you are easily offended by such, do not watch. Hello everyone, Nintas Commander here, and welcome to another episode of my video reviewer series. So in this video, I'm going to be talking about IGN's review on Dragonball Raging Blast 2. Right then, so, before I continue, I want to note that Dragonball Raging Blast 2 is a video game that I love very much, as I'm sure anybody knows this, because I upload online videos of this marvellous game, and I absolutely love playing it. I think it's a lot of fun, I think it is very detailed, a lot of great stuff in it, and I think it is overall the best Dragon Ball Z game ever made. You know, which seems to be where it does work. It seems to be how with each release, the game seems to get better. Some disagree. Some people said that Dragon Ball Z BT3 is still the best one. That's their opinion. I don't think that's true. I think Raging Blast 2 is the best one so far. And I'm pretty sure Raging Blast 3, if there's going to be one, which there most likely will be, I am pretty sure that one might be even better. But for now, at this present point in time, I believe Raging Blast 2 is the best Dragon Ball Z game out there. So, you know, now, right, so what did IGN say about this game? And what do I think of their review on this game? I am going to start this by saying you are a complete and utter bunch of idiots. Yes, that's right. IGN basically took this game and made it look terrible. Right, and I don't mean that in the game. I mean among themselves, because IGN have got to be the worst bunch of reviewers I have ever seen on the internet. There are people on YouTube that I know that review video games that are like your basic everyday person. They're not even famous or anything, and I'm one of them. You know, as you guys know, I make video game reviews on my other channel. And I know plenty of other people that do reviews on games as well. And all those guys easily beat IGN. And they're only normal everyday people. So, okay, so back to the video. I have 5 huge problems with this terrible review. Right, so what's my first problem? Well, my first problem is the start of the review, the guy, Anthony, yes, I know your name, Anthony, the same idiot that reviewed Naruto US 2, who also did a shit review on that as well. Sorry for swearing, but it is shit. So, this guy said that the backgrounds are ugly in comparison to the anime. How am they? I think they look really good. I think they looked unbelievably great. And a lot of people agree with me on that. I know a lot of people that say the backgrounds in Raging Blast 2 look amazing, which they do look amazing. They are not ugly at all. If anything, I actually say they might actually be better than the animes, which has been proven on more than one factor, because Naruto Ultimate Ninja Storm 1 and 2 graphics surpass that of the anime. And so, you know, it's only logical to think that Raging Blast 2 would as well. So, no, the backgrounds are not ugly. There's plenty of great details in them. For example, if you're on the outer space stage, you can see a city in the distance, and you can also see a spaceship moving around in the background. I think it's Frieza's spaceship, but I don't know. But, and the graphics in general look really good. So, what's the problem? So, first huge problem, the graphics are not ugly, the backgrounds are not ugly, they look amazing. And I think the character models look amazing. Some people have said that the character models look like they're wrapped in plastic wrap, which, can't understand what they mean, but it doesn't bug me. I think they look good regardless. So, second problem I had with this review. The guys said that the game enables button mashing too much. Again, another inaccuracy. It does not involve button mashing too much. The game involves you comboing your follow-ups with your cancels, two of which he didn't even bring up. He just put them down as combos are deep. Wow, that's a great amount of detail there. So, you know, My problem is, the game does not involve button mashing. There are only two sections I can think of on this game that involve button mashing a little bit. Not even a lot, only a little bit. And that is your basic melee, right, where you hammer away at the square button about up to five times at the most. After that, you know, after that, you have to push another button to get something else to happen. So anyway, the second thing is your key blasts that requires you to push the triangle button. And even then, it's only up to about five times. So, you know, and everything else involves you comboing your cancels with your follow-ups. It doesn't involve button mashing at all. Like, for example, if you're playing as Goku, for instance, if you do a full rush combo, then you push triangle four times. You continue the combo, but that's only in Raging Soul mode. If you do it any other way, you're only pushing triangle three times. So no, yeah. If anything, the only time button mashing is there a bit much is when you're in Raging Soul. But again, it's a perfectly balanced system because when you're in Raging Soul, you can't do your supers and ultimates unless you've got the island that lets you do so. Again, it's all fair. But the only part of that term I agree with is when you're in Raging Soul. When you're in Raging Soul, you can do the combos, quite a lot of button mashing, but to say that the game enables it too much, not even correct. Not correct in the slightest. And another thing he said was a skilled player's combos are easily broken by a button masher. No, they are not. Again, it's actually quite easy to stop a button masher in Raging Blast 2. You either use your snap vanishing, you use your step evasion, or you use your vanishing. You know what I mean? Yeah, don't confuse snap vanishing with vanishing. By vanishing, I mean when you push R1 and push X. That's what I mean by vanishing. So again, it's actually quite easy to stop a button masher. So by saying, quite frankly, by saying the game enabled button mashing too much, and saying that a skilled player's combos are easily broken by a button masher, it only proves that you, the person that made this review, doesn't even know how to play the game properly. So, great work, IGN. You send someone to review this game who doesn't even know how to play it properly. So, third problem I had with this review. And this problem actually carries across to the Naruto UNS2 review they did as well. And that, there was too much locked content. They said that there was too much locked content because if you want all the characters, you have to play hours and hours through the galaxy mode and the battle zone to get all the items and all the supers and all the characters. That's funny because the last I checked, that is the idea of a video game. You play through the game and at certain points in the game, you are given rewards for progressing. Okay, how the hell is that a bad thing? It's not a bad thing. You know, so, again, you know, I don't see how unlocking content is a problem. It's, quite frankly, I actually think it'd be quite boring. To put it simply, what he's basically saying, two things. One, he's saying that he wants all the characters, supers, and items and everything unlocked from the very beginning. And he also says that they don't have the patience to unlock all the characters and everything else. So no, again, to really base a game off that stupid, idiotic term generally proves just how idiotic you are. So, okay, I think my point on that one. Next problem, and oh, this one actually offended me. Right, another thing that he says was it's a strictly for fans sort of game, and there'll be a small variety of people who will adore Raging Blast 2. A small minority. Doesn't this guy know anything? Does he actually know that millions of people have actually voted Dragon Ball Z as one of the best animes of all time? do you actually realise how idiotic and brain dead you actually sound by saying that? You are basically saying Dragon Ball Z has a small audience, which we know isn't true. Dragon Ball Z is like one of the biggest animes of all time. You know, I'm not saying it's the best anime out there. I think it's the best anime out there, but I'm not saying it's a standalone best. Yeah, though I actually love many animes. I used to love the Pokemon anime. I love the Naruto anime. I loved the Mario anime. I love many animes. And Dragon Ball Z is another anime that I love. And Dragon Ball Z, let's face it guys, Dragon Ball Z has taken an almighty stand. And the best part is, it ain't even. And I mean, how many movies, how many remakes, and how much effort have they put into that anime? You had Dragon Ball, then you had Dragon Ball Z, then you actually had Dragon Ball GT, but a lot of people didn't like GT. I thought it was pretty good because of, there was a lot of cool stuff in it, but I know a lot of people that hated Dragon Ball GT, to which I don't blame them to a degree, because there was a few things about GT that pissed me off. But overall, I liked it. You know, nothing compared to the first two, but it was still a pretty good sequel, but not a great sequel. So, anyway, back to my original point. Dragon Ball Z is not a small variety. Right, there are loads of people out there that love Dragon Ball Z. And I talk from experience. When I went to school, Dragon Ball Z was still being aired. And I mean the original episodes, not the remakes and all that shit. Right, when I say that, right, everybody at my school adored the show. And many people across the internet I know adored the show. So, and Dragon Ball Z, well, you know, the bottom line is, no, it is not a small variety. Now, I'm not actually done on this section yet. Another thing he actually pointed out was, as for the rest of us, it is a game that will grow wearisome after so long. Now, I find that incredibly offensive, because as for the rest of us, that tells me that he is actually trying to say that people that don't like Dragon Ball Z are the people that are in the right. That's the impression I got. I could be wrong, but that's the impression I got. That's basically the impression I got from that line. I actually took high offense from that line. So, yeah, well, unfortunately for you, Anthony, from IGN, you are a complete idiot. You do not know what you are talking about. And as far as I'm concerned, well, you deserve to be a member of IGN because IGN, the whole stupid organisation, is idiotic. So I guess it makes sense that an idiot like you should also be put into such a stupid, unorganised, untalented, unprofessional game reviewing company. So anyway, right. So my final reason on this, and why I hated this ridiculous review, right. Actually, the last thing was something that wasn't even in the review. It was actually how uninformative it was. The review was only like just under 3 minutes. Now, I know that you can go to IGN.com for the full written review and all that crap, but let's face it, guys. Right, people prefer in this day and age to actually watch and hear rather than read about something. Let's face it, you know. I mean, when I made my Raging Blast 2 review, I made it as informative as I could be. I also put a good amount of information in the description, but nevertheless, there was still more to watch than to stupid read. So no, right. The review was uninformative, it didn't bring up anything of significance, it didn't mention anything that was good about it, it only hammered on the wrong. Right, and to me, there isn't that much wrong about it. There's hardly anything wrong. There's only two things in Raging Blast 2 that I did not like. And these aren't even big things. The first thing, there was no story. But this is actually remedied partly by the fact that you've got Galaxy Mode. Now, admittedly, I liked Galaxy Mode. I thought it was a nice change of pace because they keep going over the same thing over and over again. So, to me, Galaxy Mode was a nice change of pace, so I had no problems with that. It just would have been nice to have had a little bit more story. You know, even if it wasn't on a big radius. The second thing was the customization system. of the customization system really did kind of bug me. I actually think the customization system was the worst part of Raging Blast 2. But again, it wasn't a bad customization system, it was an okay one. There's just a few too many flaws with it, like the limit points aren't high enough. There's a few items that they took out that I wish were still there. Yeah, they did go to work on some of the cheap items and made them less cheap, which I did like. But some of the items take up too many limit points, and that's basically it. But even again, it's not a bad thing, it's an okay thing. So anyway, overall, this video, it would be kind to give this video a 1 out of 10. So that's why, guys, I give this video a 0 out of 10. There was nothing good about it. There was nothing informative about it. It was just some guy going on about how he hated the game. And he also quoted at the end how it was a cash-in on nostalgic. This video sucks balls. The guy that made it, if I was IGN, I'd fire this idiot. But what can I say? I guess he just won't, because that's what IGN are. A bunch of idiots that get a good game and basically put it down. And I don't just mean on this game, they have done it on many other games. So anyway, people, I think I've gone on for a bit too long. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you didn't, then I apologise. If you did, then leave a comment, whatever. So, see you all later. Have a good day.